G'day Dark Realmers, it's horror author and illustrator Michael J. Elliott with you again, and today we're looking at our final part of upcoming movies for 2017. So grab popcorn, just a small one because these are only trailers, grab a pen so you can jot down the name of any movie that you like and its release date, and we'll get started, okay? Okay, well, there's been a long tradition in Hollywood, in the Hollywood horror genre, to create movies about summoning up creatures by saying their name, or reading a book, or using some sort of spell. And you'll be pleased to know that in 2017, that trend continues with the Bye Bye Man. Now, if you were a fan of the Australian film Babadook, or you remember the film Candyman, this may be right up your alley. So let's take a look, Dark Realmers.
If you say his name, or even think it, he'll come for you. He makes us see things.
Don't say it, don't think it.
He makes us do things.
Don't say it, don't think it.
He spreads like a virus.
Don't say it, don't think it.
We're all losing our minds.
Don't say it, don't think it.
What do you see?
We have to help them!
No, it's a trick!
Well, one of the reasons movies such as The Bye Bye Man work so well is because they tap into a basic function in human nature that if you say don't do something, you automatically want to do it. If you tell someone you can't have it, they automatically want to have it. And you just have to look at history for that. Look at Prohibition in the United States. The government said you can't have alcohol anymore. Did that stop people? No, they wanted alcohol and they go to any lengths to get it. So by using that sort of you can't have, don't do it, you automatically set up the tension for the audience because they know that straight away someone's going to be, oh no, I'm not going to think about it, and they do, and then we're all set for the consequences. Okay, Dark Realmers, here's one for all the guys out there. Not saying that you girls won't enjoy it, but this one's about a group of guys going out on a bachelor party. And they end up at one of a very dark and mysterious club that looks ultimately creepy. And I'm sure the trailer will give you a great idea of this. And guys, if you're planning, you know, a stag night for your mate who's getting married, I'd avoid this club like the plague.
It's dude time. We don't want anything getting back to the bride-to-be. Let's light this up!
Wow, sucks. My brother's getting married and I have to deliver.
I know a place. We probably get you in. This is a bad idea.
Where the hell are we?
Don't lose him.
Whoa. He's turning. Follow him.
Oh, shit. Welcome. Yes. Happy stag party!
Ladies and gentlemen, we had some first-timers with us tonight!
What do you call this?
Murder.
Gentlemen, what do you want?
Something wild.
I'm just the thing.
Something else.
statue belongs to me.
Okay, Dark Realms, now where would the year in movies be if we didn't have at least one movie of a family or a parent, single parent, moving into a new home with a slightly creepy child? And that's what this one gives you. So let's take a look at this one and see what you think, Dark Realms.
In a couple days, it'll be just like home.
Hi. Oh, you must be Angela.
Let me introduce you to Adrian.
Hey, Adrian. It's okay.
Just so you know, Adrian isn't your typical 9-year-old. My son stopped speaking about 2 years ago, right after my husband died.
Don't they know what happened in that house?
Mother, father, two kids, just gone.
We found several dead animals killed in some type of ritual.
Do you mean sacrificed? Is someone here?
It's time to come out now, okay? You've been under here the whole time. But if you're here...
Ah, the joys of parenthood. Not. Okay, Dark Realms, let's change the pace slightly. Now, I'm a huge fan of author Dan Brown. Of course, I read The Da Vinci Code, I watched the movie Angels and Demons, and in 2017, the film adaptation of one of his newest works, Inferno, is about to hit the screen. Now, I read the book and absolutely loved it because the whole premise, just like The Da Vinci Code deals with hidden meanings in Da Vinci's paintings. This one deals with hidden signs, symbols, etc., revolving around Dante's Inferno. Now, for those of you who aren't familiar with Dante's Inferno, it's a classical piece of literature which deals with Dante traveling through the 9 levels, or I think it may be 7 levels, don't quote me on that, of hell, and each one's different. And of course we have Tom Hanks back as the college professor who is set to unravel the mystery around this. So if you're a fan of mysteries, solving things where some of the protagonists are decidedly creepy, you're going to like this. So let's take a look at Inferno.
It appears you're out of options. Tell me about the threat known as Inferno. Professor Langdon, we need your help. 3 days ago, a man killed himself. We think it was part of something much bigger. There was a package in his pocket.
And what was it?
Dante's Inferno.
Dante defined our modern conception of hell 700 years ago.
But these circles of hell have been rearranged.
Why Dante?
Why this map of hell?
Dante. Dante's death mask.
Yes.
We've got to get to Florence.
I need access to the Dante mask.
The Dante mask is no longer here. It was stolen. Here's the security footage.
Professor, that looks like you.
I have no memory of taking that mask.
You did? I just saw you.
I want to know what I'm involved with.
Why was someone shooting at you?
Everything is out of focus.
Professor, you are having visions, aren't you? The people behind this would do anything to protect the truth. You have no idea what they're capable of.
This is what I have been seeing.
Look, look, look. This is not in the original painting.
Here's another one. Prophecy.
Oh my God.
Dante's Inferno isn't fiction. It's a prophecy. Someone created a plague.
Our population is spiraling out of control. Inferno is the cure.
They're gonna wipe out half the world's population unless we find this virus.
They left a trail.
You won't be able to trust your own thoughts for a while. Human lives are at stake. If a plague exists, you know what government will do to get it.
The professor has become a liability.
Go, go, let's get him. Here, here. There's always a way out.
It's nice to have you back, Professor.
If this plague is real,
then we only have 48 hours to stop an extinction-level event.
I will do everything I can to find it.
You know when you read a book, Dark Realmers, and you visualise what the main character looks like in your mind, and you see him in a particular way? Well, when the Da Vinci Code came out, I just could not picture Tom Hanks as the main character. I just didn't think physically it was him. But I have to admit, I've been convinced in his portrayals, he has really, really shown, you know, the great side of that character that Dan Brown created. And I'm also really pleased that Ron Howard, who's directed all the other Dan Brown adaptations, is back in the director's helm, because there's always a really nice continuation feel for a movie when the director who is tried and trusted is back. And so I'm looking forward to Inferno. I recommend you read the book. It's fantastic read, very engrossing. And then follow it up by watching the movie. All right, Dark Realmers, now back to the creepy, you know, dark, what's lurking around the corner type movie. This one's called Lights Out, and it's directed by James Wan, who was the director of The Conjuring, which was one of the most popular movies released. And also, you may remember that I showed you the clip for that of Conjuring 2 in part 2 of our look at movies. So check this one out. It looks very creepy, very atmospheric. And if you like that sort of what's the secret behind this child, or why is this family going through that, you'll probably enjoy this one, Dark Realmers.
See you tomorrow.
Now, one of these nights, you could let me...
He's sexy. I like you. A lot.
Hello?
Your brother fell asleep in homeroom this morning for the third time in the past week.
Where's mom?
Someone keeps on coming over.
Yeah.
Her name's Diana.
What did you say?
Hi, mom.
Hey, you wanna talk about it?
I've been sleeping with the lights on. Every time I turn them off, there's this woman. She doesn't like the light.
I know, I see her too.
Mom?
What's up? Did we wake you?
What?
I want to tell you a story. Long time ago, I had a friend named Diana. I found out something really bad happened to her. But she came back. She's gonna stay. As long as you keep the lights out. A dead woman in this house. Oh, God!
Everyone is afraid of the dark, and that's what she feeds on.
Okay, Dark Realm, is the next one is a slight warning about partying too hard and be careful of recreational drugs because you don't know where they lead. And in a horror film, you know the effects are not going to be quite the standard, party on, nice feeling type feelings you are meant to get with drugs. Now, of course, Hollywood doesn't really, produce movies with, a message. Well, not in horror films anyway. Okay, there are anti-drug films out there, of course, but it's strange that, even though it's illegal and everything, it's become such a part of culture, especially in movies where drug taking seems like the norm. Now, I'm not condoning it, or I'm not an advocate of drug taking. I'm really, quite neutral on the subject. But this movie may think you twice about, what you get up to in the club. So let's have a look at this one, Dark Realmers. It's called Recover.
I just want my last night as a high schooler to be a good one. Let's go dancing.
We're gonna have so much fun.
Cheers.
A recovery app on your phone.
I'll check it out.
Your phone is here.
Let's just find my phone and find Kim and get the hell out of here. Oh my God. That's me.
Everything's locked.
You can't leave.
Run!
What the hell are you doing to me?
Yeah, I definitely think I'll stick to caffeine. And I apologise for that, Dark Realmers, because that movie was actually released in 2016, but the reason I included it was because it looked quite interesting and I thought it may be one that you're interested in either hiring or buying on DVD or Blu-ray. Okay, now the next one we have is something that really appeals to me. One of my favourite types of book and movie are the stalkers. Those people who suddenly become obsessed and fixated with ordinary people, and slowly their behavior becomes more intense and more violent and a lot creepier. And Hollywood's done a lot of these films. I can name two just off the top of my head: Single White Female, also Sleeping with the Enemy, Swim Fan, that's another one. Well, here's a new one called Pet, and this one is, it's the standard, stalker type one, but the whole theme behind it is this stalker works in a pet shelter, and the woman he stalks decides to end his stalking in a rather unique and quite scary sort of way. So let's take a look at Pet.
Hey,
Remember me?
I was just wondering if you wanted to get maybe dinner. I don't know about you, but I love seafood. There's a place on Wilshire. Yeah, I'll be kidding. Tonight? Holly, right? Holly Garling.
Yes, Eric.
Hey, babe.
I'm serious though, Hall. Move on already.
Someone's popular.
Who's the guy?
I already sort of have a boyfriend, so.
No, you don't.
You're keeping a girl in a cage.
I'm not doing this for me. I'm doing this for you.
Stop! Stop!
Stop! You just have it all figured out, don't you? Seth's got a little crap. You don't notice how lonely you really are.
This isn't about us. I'm trying to save you.
Then do it. Save me.
Yeah, well, I definitely wouldn't watch that one if you're planning a trip to the pet shelter to adopt another animal. Okay, Dark Realmers, here we go with one that's another in the family moving into the haunted house or, you know, creepy house type genre. But this one's a little bit different. It's called Remains, and it's about a family, and they move into a beautiful old Victorian home, and the young son finds a box of old trinkets and so forth in the attic. Well, the twist with this one is that those trinkets are actually, you know, possessed or haunted, and each member of the family who takes one of these trinkets gradually gets possessed and taken over, which is a nice little spin. So let's take a look at Remain.
This is beautiful.
Cannot believe you're making us move, so this is actually gonna happen.
It smells like cookies in here.
I think this move is going to be the best thing for all of us.
Make sure you count to 50.
One Mississippi. Two Mississippi.
This stuff is awesome.
Three Mississippi.
My kids found this very old chest in the attic.
Four Mississippi. It must have belonged to the people who used to live here. Five Mississippi.
Did you look into the history of the house?
Madame Addison's House of Spiritualism was a well-known place for social seances. Madame Addison was found strangled to death in her home. Many believe it was the outcome of a seance gone horribly wrong.
Help me, Daddy.
I keep having these hallucinations.
I'm just playing, Daddy. Burn them.
Yeah, I know Dark Realms. That's another one that was released in 2016. But honestly, I thought it was so good just by the trailer that, once again, I thought you might enjoy that for your movie collection. Okay, let's get started on something a little bit different now. And it's another one of those creepy mystery thrillers. And this one's about a missing person and how it unfolds. And it looks very subtle, but it's one of those ones that I think it's more psychological. It's more where you're waiting for something to happen and you're not quite sure about the character's motivation. So check this one out, Dark Realm.
Where is he?
He is probably driving here.
Hi, you have reached the voicemail of Paul Hunger.
What are you doing?
Paul's late.
You worried?
Tell me a little more about these hikes. You called him survivalist?
You know, he takes the bare minimum. He eats edible plants, catches his own food.
Dr. Hunger, a professor of ornithology at Ohio University, was on an excursion when he did not return home as planned.
We sent two separate rescue teams to the last two areas of the cliffs and the caves that we can safely access, and we found nothing. I just wanted you to know we followed this last lead and it went nowhere.
Are you really pulling your men off the case?
We also talked to the grad student, Miss Lorne.
Who?
We were working on a piece together. We were just good friends. I just wonder if he's off on some experiment somewhere.
We're not friends. I'm not even sure I believe you.
Why is it closed off?
I don't know.
It's too dangerous. There are significant cliffs in that area. If he fell, it just would have been over.
I don't want to do this anymore.
Why not?
I don't see the point.
What are you doing?
Watching you.
It's just like a walking cliche of denial. I just feel something.
You know what? I feel plenty.
Can't see anything. Look at me. Look at me.
Okay, Dark Realmers, here's another one based on that familiar territory of a family looking for a new beginning and moving into a creepy haunted house. Now, the fact that Hollywood keeps making these shows how popular they still are. And this one's called The Disappointments Room. And it looks very creepy, very atmospheric. And you have to remember, you can write... As an author, I can tell you this, you can write creepy, dark things, and it gets very, very hard to come up with new and frightening ways to engage readers and even audiences. So I tip my hat off to all the screenwriters out there who keep coming up with ways to chill audiences. Check this one out and see if you agree.
Ready for your new house?
This is a new beginning.
New beginning.
Hello?
This room's not on the floor plans.
Dan, you got that look that concerns me.
Don't get sick again, Mommy.
There's no one else here.
I'm sick you.
From haunted houses to creepy, abandoned and burnt out asylums, this next one looks really frightening. It's called Eloise and it's about a man who is set to inherit his father's estate. But there's one complication. His sister Eloise was committed to an insane asylum, but there's no record of her ever being released. So before the estate can be settled, they need to find the either death certificate or some sort of record indicating what happened to Eloise. And of course, yes, they take a trip into the old spooky abandoned asylum, and that's where the action really starts happening. Dark Realm.
I hate to be the one to tell you, but your father has passed.
1.2 million falls to you. But a small complication has arisen. His sister was committed to Eloise Insane Asylum, but she was never released.
We have to have proof of her death.
I have to get this death certificate from that mental hospital, Eloise.
That place burned down like 30 years ago.
Quick in, quick out. Piece of cake.
Yo, what was that?
What, are you scared?
I ain't scared.
This is where they used to store the dead bodies.
This place gives me the creeps.
Oh my God. Let's get the file and get out.
Doctor, your critics have been extremely vocal about this radical therapy.
Yep, that one is definitely a recommendation to have your health insurance right up to date. Okay, the next one we've got is called Abattoir, and it's the director is someone who's been involved with the Saw franchise. So you can be sure that it's going to be very gruesome and horrifying and terrifying and all that. And it's the haunted house again, but with a twist. And it's all about a woman who explains that before she bought her house, it was the scene of a home invasion where a husband and wife were killed. Now that's enough just to creep you out just there, but this is where the story progresses with the main character also buying a house. And let's check this one out, Dark Realm.
Years before I took over the ownership, there was a nasty home invasion.
Let's go!
A husband and wife killed.
In your house?
More specifically, in the hallway.
And the hallway was gone.
Half a dozen properties bought and sold. Over a 50-year span.
Each one purchased.
After a tragic event occurred in the house.
Who buys a house and cuts the entire crime scene out of it?
I'll list in the closing papers.
Jebediah Crone. The guy's a ghost collecting ghosts.
I'm getting too close to this one.
Are you willing to build this foundation on the bones of angels? Will you fall with me, children?
Christ, no!
Jebediah Crone had been to hell, and he brought back with him some of his secrets.
Julia! You have no idea what this town has brought.
Please just tell me what he's building.
You would brave a hell for your loved ones. I would construct one for mine.
Yep, you should seriously avoid any home renovation reality TV shows before watching that one, Dark Realmers. Okay, the final one I've got for you, and believe me, I could go on and on with a heap more trailers, but by the time I got through them all, it'd be 2018. So I've just given you a sneak peek of some of the great ones that are due for release. Now, this one is a creepy take on surrogacy, and it's about a couple who take in a young girl, and she discovers they weren't able to have children, so she offers to be a surrogate for them. But she finds herself going through some really peculiar and strange changes during her pregnancy, and it's very dark, it's very atmospheric, and it looks totally engrossing. So check this one out, Dark Realmers.
Elena, I'm sorry for everything we let you go through.
We live quite alone out here. We like peace and quiet. This is your room.
I'm Louise.
Nice to meet you.
You have a big house. You have time. You have money. Why don't you have any kids?
We can't. I can't. Would you consider burying my child?
It's a girl.
Thank you for doing this.
You don't have to thank me.
Louise tells me you got these headaches.
Are you okay?
Skin irritation, headaches, dizziness, that's all part of a pregnancy.
Ah! Elena! Elena, can you hear me?
It's going to hurt me.
So how is my baby today?
It's my baby.
Stop it! Stop it! Stop it! And I want to ask for your forgiveness.
Okay, Dark Realmers, that's it for our look at horror movies due for release in 2017, part one, part two, and finally here, part three. I hope you found some movies that will pique your interest and that you'll enjoy going to the cinema to see. Let me know which ones you particularly like or which ones you're looking forward to in the comments below. Don't forget to hit subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you like our content. I produce new videos every Friday. This one's been a special exception because of 2017 just starting off. But anyway, Dark Realmers, I hope you have a great and fantastic 2017 full of great movies to watch. And I'll see you soon. And remember, Dark Realmers, stay in the light.